Masters, 45 to 49.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, when I was 14 years old, I turned on Wide World of Sports, and an American convenience store was sponsoring a team in the Tour de France. And Norman Alvis was on that team in 1990. And he is here at the Masters National Cycling Championships in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Norm, how did you feel today?
You know, I felt pretty good. I didn't want to go too early because of the heat. But the racing was a little bit dull because of that heat. And so when I finally went, I wasn't able to catch the guy in the front, but I ended up on the podium anyway.
We saw Mr. Casper got the big win out there, but you were in second place, and we were the ones screaming Storm and Norman.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate the support.
Your career is just legendary. You're the hour record holder, which you took from Albuquerque's John Fry.
That's right.
51 kilometers in an hour. 95 USPRO national champion and winner of the Herald Sun Tour, the Tour of Australia.
That's right. And late in my career, I think 97 that was.
Well, we love seeing you still racing. What's been the best part about this week in Albuquerque?
They've had excellent courses out here. It's been really well organized, great directions, and the results come out right away. It's been really well organized, and it's been fun to participate. I really enjoyed being in Albuquerque.
Three laps to go on the lap count.
So what's next up for Norm Alvis now that the world is open again?
Well, you know what? I'm glad you asked. Next up is I'm going down to Aguascalientes, Mexico. I'm going to try to set a world record for the hour. Again, as a Masters rider, 55 to 59 years old, that category. And because technology has improved so much since when I did it in the 90s, it's possible I will go 51 and a half kilometers again like I did when I was a pro. So
that would be sweet.
It would be fun. It's a fun endeavor.
If you do your age, I'll buy you a steak dinner.
If I do my age, I'll ask for more than that.
Thank you so much for your time. But tell us about in the 1980s, before you were on that tour, I'm 7-Eleven. You did a little race in Silver City that survived to this day. Tour of the Gila. Yeah. What are your memories of Gila from the old days?
I tell you what, I remember that race as a monster. And at that time when I did that race, my team captain and teammate was Kent Boston, who won earlier in the 65-69 category. So, and he's from Albuquerque. I know that's where he was. So, Tour of the Gila, that was a really, really nice race. Again, another well-organized race. And one definitely worth going to.
Awesome. Norm, thank you for your time.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Bye-bye.